closer and closer to our 99 songs.
Yes.
71.
71.
Another guest that you had on the show.
Yes, sir. I had Nisa Mendes, who's been working with a whole bunch of Indian bands. Really nice of her to send me songs that I had never heard. And that's one of the greatest things about the guest series shows. I was really excited about having this because all of the people in the music industry have been into the music that they love for such a long time. And it's not necessary that everything that I know is something that you know or someone else knows. And
you're always
learning
new
songs.
Telling people about new stuff and you're also learning about new stuff.
Exactly. And Nisa's show did that for me in a big way. So many songs that I'd never heard before.
Yeah.
And but
quite a few that I didn't hear, that I didn't know as well. But yeah, most of it was pretty familiar to me.
Pretty familiar.
So one of her choices is what is also one of my favorite bands, Nine Inch Nails.
Okay.
This is from their With Teeth album. This one's called Bite the Hand That Feeds.
That was from Nisa's guest series show, and the 72nd show that I had was something that was very special to me. It was a show that I called 13 Love Songs for the 13th April, and yes, again, it is a mushy episode. And I have
why 13th of April? What's so special?
Okay, 13th of April is special because it's an important day for me, and my fiance, my partner, my boss, my everything, we got together on the 13th of April, and this was our third year anniversary. So I said, okay, I'll put up 13 songs, and landed up putting up 26 songs, 13 original songs, and 13 songs that could have almost made the list, and beautiful songs. Forget the mush aspect behind it, forget my story behind it. 26 really, really beautiful songs for you guys to check out. And the song that I've chosen from that list, which I'm dedicating to Neha, is a song by Celine Dion. This one's called Another Year Has Gone By. Another year has gone by, and I'm still the one by your side. After everything has gone by, myself from the mush, we got down to Metallica.
Yes.
73, the classic album, the Black Album, was what was featured in the 73rd episode. And
the last good album by Metallica, in my opinion. And I'm sure quite a few out there would share that as well also.
Hmm.
But this is a Black Album.
Great song.
This is a great album.
Great song.
The song I'm going to choose is, of course, not one of the ones that you all know, but this is one of the other songs, but it's called Through the Never.
Mm-hmm.
Really, really hard-hitting and some really great lyrics as well.
There you go. 73rd episode was Metallica's Black Album. 74th episode was an episode on covers that became a lot more popular than the original artists. And I'm letting Luke pick up another song from that, and that's gonna be.
I'm gonna choose Hard to Handle. Mm. Most of you know it by the Black Crowes, but the original song was done by one of the biggest, greatest, bestest. I know that's not a word, but still, it completely describes.
Oh yeah, it totally
the gentleman
does.
Who I'm gonna name, Mr. Otis Redding. The King of Soul. Boys and things will come by the dozen, but that ain't nothing but drugstore loving. Pretty little thing, let me like to count, cause mama, I'm so hard to handle now, yes, around.
I made the 75th show a little more personal. About a few weeks ago when the IPL was happening, I wrote a song for the Mumbai Indians. I'm a big Mumbai Indians fan, and I wanted to write a song to capture the entire essence of the team and how well they were doing. It's unfortunate that they didn't win the IPL, but that's all right because the song now stays valid for a longer time because the last line of the song says, "We will be champions." Mumbai, Mumbai, we're the Mumbai Indians. Yeah, Mumbai, Mumbai, we're the Mumbai Indians. '76 was another guest series show. It was Parag Kamani's guest series show.
Yeah, Parag. I mean, most of you guys probably don't know Parag, but Parag also has been, part of the music industry for a very, very long time.
Yeah.
And like another friend of mine, Arjun, who started off the guest series.
Yeah.
Parag has also been a part of the music industry and also a great music fan and very knowledgeable also about music.
Extremely, yeah.
So it was also great to see that you had him on the show.
And
he's so passionate about the music that he loves. And
exactly.
He's one of the gentlest guys you can ever talk to and speak to.
Yes, so you can definitely make out that both of us feel very, we both think very highly of him, and it was my honor to have him as a guest on the show, and there's a song that you've chosen.
But from all his choices, one of the very exciting choices that Parag had chosen. Parag, what are you thinking? There's a song called Squeeze Box by The Who. Well, it's also been covered by one of the 80s singers called Laura Branigan, which is where I first heard it. But then later on, my dad told me that it's actually by The Who, so when I went back and heard The Who song, then much later on in life when I knew what Squeeze Box really meant. So it's fascinating to see that The Who wrote a song about the
Squeeze Box.
Listen to the song.
Let you discover what it is all about.
Listen to the lyrics very carefully.
Mama's got a squeeze box, daddy never sleeps at night.
One of the songs that he mentioned in his show, Parag mentioned in his shows, was a song by Justin Hayward, a song called Forever Autumn. And I'm choosing that as the song from the 77th episode because when I heard this song on Parag's show, I was blown away. I can't believe I had never heard of something called War of the Worlds before that. I loved it so much that I actually had this CD ordered after the episode. So this is an album I fell in love with after I heard it on Parag's show. I did a complete special over that in the 77th episode. It's called Jeff Wayne's War of the Worlds, and the song that I've chosen is Forever Autumn by Justin Hayward.
The summer sun is fading as the year grows old, and darker days are drawing near.
Alright, the next album, something I know you're a big fan of, Rattle and Hum.
Yes, the Irish Boys. Yes, they're somehow Irish anyway, so you know. Yes.
Okay.
My great-grandfather was Irish, and so I have Irish blood and lineage in me. But of course, born and brought up in India. Like, to get back to you two,
yes.
Rattle and Hum again, one of the great rock movies ever made.
Yep.
It was done by Phil Jeannou way back in the late 80s, 89, I think. Mm. And one of the exciting parts of the film is we follow you two through the aftermath of the Joshua Tree, and of course their upcoming tour. That happened as well also. Mm. And they visit Elvis's home, they visit Graceland, and they try and, you know, search for the roots of the blues. Mm. So they go to, you know, Mississippi and, you know, New Orleans, and they see all these black musicians still on the street playing. So this is the song where this black man is sitting on the street singing Freedom for My People, which then segues into the live performance of Silver and Gold, where Bono goes on this little kind of anti-apartheid rant, and then he says, am I bugging ya? Don't mean to bug ya. Okay, Edge, play the blues. It's a fantastic sequence, check it out.
The warden said, the exit's sold. If you want a way out, silver ring.
The 79th episode was a lot of fun too. Paul Anka singing rock songs in a swing way. The album was called Rock Swings, and I featured the entire album. And the song that I've chosen, incidentally, from this album is by originally by Van Halen, a song called Jump. Check out Paul Anka doing Jump his way.
Might as well jump!
Jump!
Go ahead, jump!
Now the 80th episode was something special, and Luke really liked it. He just heard it right now.
This was something really, really exceptional. Now, I mean, all of us have played video games at some point in time in our lives, and we all know what the early video games were like. The Nintendo ones, which had all those blips and blops and all those kind of really electro kind of sounds, which are used in music today, but that time they were soundtracks to, you know, little video games.
Games, yeah.
So what somebody has done is taken those sounds and, you know, rearranged the whole of Dark Side of the Moon, the Pink Floyd album. So imagine listening to Dark Side of the Moon that sounds like a Nintendo
game.
It's one of the most amazing things I've ever heard.
Stunning stuff.
That's a great find.
A great find?
Absolutely fantastic.
That was the 80th episode. We'll come back with 81.